Singaporeans have gone to the polls to vote in what's shaping up to be the hardest fought general election in the country's half century as an independent state. Despite being one of the world's wealthiest countries, with a higher GDP per person than the US or the UK, many Singaporeans are angry over slowing economic growth, an influx of foreign workers, and a sizable gap between rich and poor.
And 是不是大家能够应付啊？从新一代来讲，他们就希望自己有一个小天地，租屋的问题能够解决吗？
The biggest problem, I think, is the insane immigration policy that has, indiscriminately allowed so many immigrants without planning for all the infrastructural support for such a big population. That's why everything is breaking down. So I think an ordinary citizen suffer.
2.5 million registered voters have begun casting their ballots, and a result is expected in the early hours of Saturday morning. Singaporean elections have always been one-sided affairs, with the People's Action Party winning every general poll since independence. And although the PAP is virtually assured of regaining its majority, the poll will give some indication of whether or not voters continue their drift away from the ruling party. That alienation with PAP policies was highlighted in the 2011 election, when the ruling party received a record low share of the popular vote, although it held on to 81 of the 87 parliamentary seats. For the PAP, today's election is a chance to reconnect with the electorate and win back voter support. Prime Minister Lee Hsien Loong has responded to voter discontent by slowing the influx of foreign workers, lowering housing costs, and improving the social safety net. But some voters want a stronger opposition in Parliament to place a check on the ruling party.
We have to have an opposition so that whatever the government do, you know, is some they are watching it. But so far, I think the government is doing a good job.
Mark Wembridge, Financial Times, Singapore.